And I don't see a partition life type legend. So I'm gonna make my own, okay? Architects don't call it partition type legends. They call it wall type legend, right? So for you it's a partition, for architects a wall, because it can be exterior, it can be interior. So for now, we're not gonna be that picky. We're just gonna, you know, just wing it a little bit. All right, so the first step is to right click and create a new legend. And you probably have an idea what this is about because we did that on doors, remember? We did some of this on doors, door types. So right click on legends folder in your browser and create a new legend. The name of the legend will be uppercase partition type legend. And do you remember what is the most important thing to start with in legend? Remember the door type legend? What do we put in it? What's the first thing? No. We use something called, see, this is a good refresher. We use something called legend component. What's a legend component? It's the graphic representation of any family, any rabbit family. It can represent any rabbit family. Because partitions are rabbit families, we can turn them into rabbit families. So select your annotate menu, component pull down, legend component, and go ahead and place this symbol anywhere on this canvas. This is just a nothing. This is just a nothing, okay? It says cable tray, but actually it's like a placeholder. And go ahead and use the pull down menu for the rabbit family name and select a type of family. I may want to say something about this. The name is composed of two parts. The first part, for example, let's pick this one. The first part of the name is walls. What is walls? What is walls in our dictionary? It's the rabbit category name, right? Are you with me? Do you remember that? Rabbit category name. What is basic wall? That's the family name. What is interior? 2x6 partition 1 hour. That's the type name. So category name, family name, type name, all in the same row with a colon in between. Everybody got that clear? This is very, very important. I'm really big on, you may have heard me repeat myself a lot, as I love talking about category names and type names, because what I found out there in the real world, architects, engineers, they are so careless about the categories and they end up using the wrong category. It doesn't work. Rabbit does not work for you if you're going to be frivolous about it. You have to be very purposeful about it. So you can't use an interior wall for an exterior wall. Don't do it. It doesn't work. It may work. It may look the same, but eventually you're going to get in trouble with Rabbit because of how Rabbit parametrics behave. Okay? If it's a piece of furniture, it's not the casework. It's either casework or furniture, it can be both. So in this case, you are using an interior partition. Go ahead and select interior partition. Doesn't matter which one. And replace the placeholder with that. This is a symbol that represents an interior partition, 2x6 partition 1 hour. Got it? Mm-hmm. Now, what you want to do first is we want to change the view to a fine level of detail and zoom in. Now the scale of the view seems to be a little bit curious. What should we do? Should we go to 3/4 of an inch? Look at that. You see what happened? When you go to 3/4 of an inch, what do you see? You start to see the gypsum wallboard, and you see a dark outline around the partition because it's in section, it's cut. Right? That's a little better. Now we can talk about the scale later, but that's not our topic. But I want you to understand that that's almost, I would say 99% of what you do should be in fine level of detail, because you guys are detail-oriented people, right? While, you know, if you're dealing with a civil engineer, you know, the scale is 1 inch equals 50 feet, who cares? You're not gonna see any of that stuff at that scale, right? So core level of detail is fine. Structural engineers are the same. When you do their floor framing plan, all they care about is just a line that presents the beam. They couldn't care less if they see the entire beam with all the details in it. That doesn't matter for them, because they're not interested in geometry, they're interested in the analytics, right? They analyze the building for gravity forces and lateral forces and hurricane and earthquake. For them, it's analysis. For us, it's geometry. We need to see it, like the actual thing, the physical, because it has a width and a length and a height and a depth, and it can fit or doesn't fit in the room. So this is, for us, it's different. For them, it's a different story. All right. So I'm glad. I hope I just made a difference for you. Now this representation is in section view. What we're going to do is we're going to turn this into a floor plan view. So in the pull down, we're going to change it to a floor plan view. And then since this is a partition, I can make my partition 4 feet long. So it doesn't look like, I can make my partition 4 feet long as a sample. This is like a sample wall. So it doesn't look like, you know what I'm saying? Like a little blip on the page. I want it to look like a partition, like something long, not short. Okay. All right, now that we have that, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to select that partition. I'm going to use the copy command to copy this down. Now, if you want to use the power user way of working, you can use control drag, control and drag with the mouse instead of copy. That would work as well. So as you become a power user, then these types of shortcuts can help you become much more efficient. The next, so we have three copies of the same partition, right? Okay. I'm not quite ready yet to tag the material of this partition. Well, I want to know how big this thing is. So I'm gonna go to my annotate menu, select the detail line command, and create a rectangle. Detail line command, create a rectangle like so. Why would I do that? Because that's what it's gonna look like on the sheet. And I'll put another line down here for the title, right? So I'm creating a box. I'm creating a simple box made up of detail lines and a place for the title. And the title, I'm gonna command, text command, the big A, in the annotate menu, to create a piece of text here. And the text is, oh, by the way, that really bugs me. Hold on a second. Text command, I can't stand this font. Can I change it, please? I'm gonna use a quarter inch. Arial, why quarter inch?
Because that's standard.
Because quarter inch text is standard for titles, and eighth inch text is standard for the body of the text. Everybody does that, okay? So unless it's something special. So quarter inch text, and the name is partition type legend. If I can spell it right. And uppercase, right? And then we're gonna stretch this piece of text like so, stretch, so that it touches both sides of the text box. And not only that, we're going to change its horizontal alignment to center alignment in the properties, right? Center alignment in the properties. If you want, if you prefer, you can click on this. This will give you the same result. This is center alignment over here. All right, so this is nothing fancy here, it's just a box for text. So we're making our own box. Why would I make this into a legend? Because I can put it on multiple sheets. Let me repeat that one more time. I can do this in drafting view. No, not really, I can't do this in drafting view. I cannot put the legend component in drafting view, it doesn't work. A legend component can only be placed in a legend view. But I chose to go with the legend because I can put it on multiple sheets. If I have 5 floor plans, I can put this on 5 floor plans and I don't have to make multiple copies of it. Okay, so one partition was 2x6 partition 1 hour. The next one is going to be a different one. I'm gonna pick a different, doesn't matter which one you pick, by the way. So just pick 3 types of walls. Now, let me sit down for a second, otherwise my back starts to hurt. All right, what we're gonna do next is we're going to save the drawing, save the project, and I'm gonna use something called material tag, okay? Look at my screen to see where the material tag is located. Material tag. Click on material tag. Revit says, I don't have a material tag for you. Would you like to load one? Yes. Let's load the material tag. Where do you think it's going to be located? It's in the annotations folder, architectural, material tag. Do you see it? Revit says, you're trying to load the material tag which already exists. Do you want to, what do you want to do, override? Yes, pick the second option, always the second option. Override the existing version and its parameter values. Now, point. Oh God, this is so bad. Good? I thought it was bad. Point to the partition and click and place it. What do you get? Question. You get a question mark. Why do you get a question mark? So the question is, what is it tagging? Tag, and let's go to, I'm gonna go edit family. You don't have to do this with me. This is tagging material description. Do you see that? Material description, another view. Because I can't use the wall command. I can't use the wall command in a legend view. So I have to go to another view, click on the wall command, and I'm gonna find that partition on this list. Find it, okay, click on it. Edit type, preview, edit structure. Right, so what are we going to do? We're going to change the material description of gypsum wallboard. Do you follow? Okay, how do we go to the material browser? Yeah. We click on this browse button, the 3 dots. Browse, gypsum wallboard. Anybody sees a description box that's empty? Right there, you see? Whatever we type here, isn't that great? It's gonna show up in the tag. Problem solved. You got everybody with me now? This is the secret of this whole scenario. Yeah, it's just a division. Yeah, don't make it too complicated, okay? I want to comment on what Chris said. It's not a size of the gypsum wallboard, it's a description. Besides, it's a different story. So if I told you what is this on the floor, you would say carpet. Or you may say broadloom carpet. Or you may say carpet tiles. That's enough. That's enough description. Got it? If you want to go more detail, then you go to the manufacturer, the model number, the cars, the website, the keynote, you know what I'm saying? CPT1, CPT2, this goes in here. There's a lot. I can put on the cover sheet. Ta-da! See it? What do we do with that extra title down there at the bottom? Can we make it no title? No title is the proper way to do it. All right, end of story. Do you have any questions?